What is your question?
You said if these items get lost or stolen, is that due to offenses of the Pujari or?
Sometimes, not on all cases, but some cases. Sometimes we see that our big bag is not here in the mission. It is due to our lackness of it. Very often, disregarding, not checking for sure. Then, and we will go to any devotees who likes.
This is most of you.
Some cases, ditties. Ditties are himself a Krishna.
Asun, asun!
So, if anyone neglect them, like when Gopinath, Gopinath and Madan Mohan were neglected, Radha Damodar neglected in Vrindavan by the devotees, then they cheated them and they went to Jaipur. So, we should not try to be always. That is why in Vrindavan, sometimes Putana comes, sometimes Agasur comes. Why? To renew their love and affection to Krishna. Sometimes when Yashoda taking Krishna in lap, here and there, always meeting, then he sometimes be there.
Familiar, complacent.
No so much charm for Krishna. Together they so long time. So Krishna sees that, oh, now she has no so much strong attraction for me. So he calls Putana. Yashoda Rani, I'm raping her. So at that time his love and affection revived. Again she sees that, oh, Krishna sees that, oh, again, some like that too. Once Krishna was waiting, mother, I want to go in your lap, I want to take your breath. Mercy, mercy. No, you are very good. At once, Aghasura or Sakatasura was there. And again Krishna went in a very miserable condition. And Yashoda love and affection was renewed. Again, for so many days she could not give up Krishna from her life. Obviously. Again anything comes, again Krishna calls it, why do you mind? So we should not try to be like that, neglecting Harinam, neglecting deities, neglecting Tulasi.
I have a songbook also.
Thank you.
one that could be on.
Thank you. Came and he tested all kinds of bhakti, but he could not give the process in which the neophyte devotee, the Kanishtha Adhikari, will come. No electricity? What are you
doing? Who
is then called?
The Guru will take care of everything.
Can you switch off my microphone?
not working.
Can you switch off my tape before you check the part?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. It was behind.
Just the red one.
How in Nephi, Prakrit or Kanishtha Adhikari will come into Madhyam Adhikari. And Madhyam Adhikari will gradually come, cultivate their bhaktis to Uttam Adhikari. And Uttam Adhikari, how he can come? In Swarup Siddha Bhakti, and a Swarup Siddha Bhakti will come into Nitya Siddha, Vastu Siddha Bhakta, Premi Bhakta. I have explained Upadeshamrita's four shlokas in London. And I'll easily tell them. Keep this slope and beginning here. We should not give our attention to anything. All intention should be good. If you read anything, you should be absorbed in that. I'm serving this thing. And I'm taking all these instructions in my heart, not only to hear by this ear and to speak out. There is a very beautiful story that in India there was a king named Brahmaditya. He has so many nine jewels, court jewels. All nines were so loved. Among them, Kalidas was supreme, intelligent. One day, a person like madman, having don't do anything.
And the skull.
Skull. Narmunda,
skull,
taking the time, quite naked, so much dirty, and he came in the council of Vikramaditya, and he put that skull on the desk and told, I've heard that there are so many intelligent jewels in your court, council, let them come here. And they should test whether this, the person whose skull is this, is called
skull
is this, he was intelligent or not intelligent. He was full, quite full and rusted. 8 jewels were there, very learned person, and whole council was full of. But none was ready to give the reply. Only this was a skull. Nothing was there. So how to taste it? Then that mad person began to laugh and he told that all bogus persons, foolish, nonsense, I heard and I found it here, bogus. So I'm going and he took his skull and was to go. In the meantime, Kalidas came. King prayed that madman, oh, wait a little. My one of the council is coming. And he may answer your question. He put her that skull on the desk again. And Kalidas came. Again, this question was done to Kalidas, and Kalidas took a very long
stick
of
coconut stick.
coconut stick, you know.
Parbhumi.
Very fine.
Use parbhumi.
And very long.
Coconut
by which?
Is to broom.
Sweet.
Is to broom.
Yes.
No. One stick, you do. And went to that skull and put in the this ear. And it went. He said. Then he told, your question is answered. You understand?
Yeah.
Oh, you should clear it. Again, king told that I am not understanding. He told that if anything comes here and goes here, that person is surely a foolish person. And if it was not to come out here and to go here, that it was surely a very intelligent person. So this is called of that person originally was very foolish. So hearing all things, but not taking here to cultivate all these teachings are like foolish person. They cannot close, they cannot develop their Krishna. So what? You have come from so many distance. Very, very far this life. Don't take these teachings here and then take it here. It should come here. Well, let us follow this. We have not any of us have not come to gain any worldly thing. We have come here that how we can develop our Krishna consciousness, Krishna bhakti. Generally we are of Kanishtha Vidyaya. It may be rare some of us be Madhyama Vidyaya. Not Uttama Adhikari in any case. So we are either in Kanishtha Adhikari, some of us, you may be Madhyama Adhikari. So we should try to develop by hearing the instructions of Srila Rupa Goswami, explained by Srila Swamiji. When I am telling Swamiji or Bhaktivedanta Swamiji Maharaj, then you should understand that I am telling of my Siksha Gurus, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, and your Prabhupada. So, don't think that Swamiji Maharaj is not in line of Rupa Goswami. And what Rupa Goswami has told, he is not telling the same words and same thing. Because he has told so many words. Rupa Goswami has told in two lines, in one slope. And Swamiji has explained in 10 pages. So he is not telling other thing. Only he is illuminating the same thing for those is helping or not understanding. So take in the same line. And also I am reading and I will explain Swamiji explanation. So don't think that he is telling other things because his words are not same as Swamiji. Swamiji is not actually telling the same word that Rupa Goswami has told. But the meaning and purpose and the eternal motive is the same. So I am bringing from Krishna iti jasya garin tam manasatri dirchasti cheta pranat bhishya bhajan chanisham sutrusya bhajana vidya mananya manna nindadi sunya sidimep satinisham. Fourth sloka was relation with Vaishnava. How to serve, how to associate Vaishnava. By
six
activities. Dadati pratigrihnam. Bhujam akhyati prichati bhungte bhojyate chaiva sarvidham priti laksharam vihasto. I have explained this. So I now come to this. Krishna iti jasya dhyayam tam manasa. You should read the translation. You have no?
One should mentally honor the devotee who chants the holy name of Lord Krishna. One should offer humble obeisances to the devotee who has undergone spiritual initiation and is engaged in worshipping the deity. And one should associate with and faithfully serve that pure devotee who is advanced in undeviated devotional service and whose heart is completely devoid of the propensity to criticize others.
In this translation, or even in the text, has Swamiji mentioned anywhere that the devotees should be initiated by me myself? Has he told that we should deal with the devotee only initiated by me? Has he told? Either he has told that disciples, my disciples, and their disciples only. We should think that only the disciples of my disciples are bona fide Vaishnavas. But in whole world, none are Vaishnavas. He has told. There is any particular demarcation line for this? So we should not think that he is only telling that my disciples in their conference.
Society.
In Vaishnava society. Even in not Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, even he may be of Sri Sampradaya, Ramana Sampradaya, anyone, any of the Sampradaya, even a person out of any Sampradaya, four Sampradaya, Vaishnava Sampradaya, he has heard anything about Krishna glory, the glory of Krishna. He has not taken initiation or name even, and he is uttering Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Swamiji has given example of his friend. He was not in the Krishna conscious society. He was not even initiated by anyone, first or second or anything. He was a famous English musician. He had not left his all bad things, eating, drinking,
smoking,
and famous in song here and there. But he has some photos of Krishna in his house, respecting, and in his famous Sangeet.
Song.
He used to tell Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Swamiji is telling in his explanation, anywhere I don't remember. Where?
Also here?
Yes,
also
here.
In this report.
This?
Yes.
So he is telling that we should think in the family of our family.
Yeah.
And he should be respected. Whether he is drinking, he has intoxicated,
yes,
or anything. And if he is initiated by anyone of Vaishnava or in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu family, this is
must respect. If he is coming, don't criticize. If he is telling me. So here he is telling me. Krishna iti jasya gri. Yes, you should read the part.
About the mediators. Like, I'll read the part
read that
you just spoke about.
No.
We can see from practical experience that there are different types of Vaishnavas. The Prakriti Sahajiyas generally chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, yet they are attached to women, money, and intoxication.
You should know the paribhasha.
Definition
of Sahajiya. There are some of devotees are telling that Narayan Maharaj is Pakka Sahajiya. But you should hear the definition of Sahajiya. What is the?
When they chant Hare Krishna, but they are attached to women, money, and intoxication.
What thing? Woman,
money, and intoxication.
But you should think, woman here, man and woman both each other. Don't think that only woman. For man, woman for? Otherwise it will be ex-party. And it will be offense for women ladies, devotees.
Although such persons may chant the holy name of the Lord.
She becomes enthusiastic.
That they think that I'm involved in omens. Anyone can tell? I drink and smoke. Or any of the all bad things. I change my sannyasi dress when I come to my home, Manzil, and I change the clothes when I go to other countries.
Even not Singapore also.
And about money, I don't want any. I want pure hearts. Only to have. Then who are Sahajiyas? Those who are telling are myself. Those who are telling not falling all these things, also they are Sahajiyas. All that. So Krishna has given intelligence to think all these things. Don't believe, blunder what?
Don't believe on merely rumors.
Today in Kali Yuga, only propaganda and rumors are most prominent weapons. But Vaishnava does not apply these things. They should be out of these things. Then again?
Although such persons may chant the holy name of the Lord, they are not yet properly purified. Such people should be respected within one's mind, but their association should be avoided. Those who are innocent, but simply carried away by bad association, should be shown favor if they are eager to receive proper instructions from pure devotees. That's pretty. Yeah.
Now come to the purpose. We will try to properly be established for Swamiji is telling. My English is not perfect, but you should take this sense. You should read in order to.
In order to intelligently apply the sixfold loving reciprocations mentioned in the previous verse, one must select proper persons with careful discrimination. Srila Rupa Goswami therefore advises.
If any question, you can ask. This is East Gopis. Not a
very
lecture.
All right. I will not be disturbed.
Srila Rupa Goswami therefore advises that we should meet with Vaishnavas in an appropriate way according to their particular status.
What is the paribhasha? Definition of Vaishnava?
He has told here Vaishnava.
What is the
definition
of Vaishnava?
Who has taken Vishnu mantra, Krishna mantra, Ram mantra,
and worshipping that deities in by same mantra, following the rules and regulations. There are all Vaishnava.
Is my disciple, so he is Vaishnava, and all are not Vaishnava. This is offense. We should not name offenses like this. Anyone by birth without cost and greed. We should adopt all this. Paribhasa, Vaishnava. Anyone who is chanting, one is initiated in Vaishnava mantra and worshipping, that is in that mantra, following the rules, all are Vaishnava. The worshipper of Ram, the worshipper of Nisimha, worshipper of Krishna, worshipper of Vishnu, in proper way, but not like Mayavadi. Mayavadi also chant Krishna name, but they are not in proper Vaishnava way. So he is telling Vaishnava. Then,
in this verse, he tells how to deal with three types of devotees. The Kanistha Adhikari, Madhyama Adhikari, and Uttama Adhikari. The Kanistha Adhikari is a neophyte who has received the Harinam initiation from the spiritual master and is trying to chant the holy name of Krishna.
One useful thing. A man has taken Harinam. What is the need of taking Diksha? Can you, anyone reply?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes. Partner, stand up.
Raghunath Bhattar.
I don't
remember. Raghunath Bhattar, yes.
Then you so sit. Yes, sir.
Prabhupada says to bring one closer to the spiritual master.
I could not understand.
In Tarumcharitamrita, Swami Maharaj says that to bring the disciple closer to Krishna, Diksha mantras are given.
What is the difference? I want to know. Between Harinam and Diksha, what is prominent, name or Diksha?
Stated Nama Chintamni Krishna Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha Guna Shudha Nitya Mukta Adnatam Nama Nama.
That you should hear properly, and if you want, you can question.
That name is none different from Nami, name of Krishna, and Krishna himself, that they're none different. So, it's stated, by chanting the holy name, Hare Krishna, then one can achieve Krishna prema. But Diksha, taking Diksha initiation, Gayatri, then that can take one to liberation, but now can give Krishna prema. So, of the two, even though there's more restriction on Diksha, but actually Harinam is more prominent.
Anyone more? Can clear?
There may be some.
You can just stand up.
Guru Maharaj, with all due respect, we heard yesterday in the introduction of your Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindu that in the life story of Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur, he was visited by Srimati Swamini Radharani herself to explain that the Kam Gayatri Mantra was so important for the revelation of Braj itself and for the devotee to actually have the full realization of the devata of this mantra. So from my understanding, from your good self, I believe that Diksha is more important than Harinam.
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he explains that
very important thing. It is not a very general or common thing.
He explains that actually Harinam is sufficient. However, is sufficient for bringing the Jivatma back to Krishna, but in our conditioned state, we have so many impurities and contaminations and anarthas. So especially, the Gayatri Mantra is very helpful for purification to help us go
forward.
What do
you mean by Gayatri Mantra?
Brahma Gayatri. And
but all the related devotees have
no
Brahma
Gayatri. All the Gayatri. Brahma Gayatri. Gayatri and Mahaprabhu Gayatri and Kam Gayatri and Gopal Gayatri.
Gopal mantra. Anything more you can tell? Hari Malati is so here.
দীক্ষা কালে গুরু
খুব খুব বেশি কালে
when guru gives diksha then he make his disciple like his own level and diksha means dibba gyanam jato daddat kurjat papasya sanchayam tasmat dikshati pratsadeshikai tatta kavidoi who is Tattavid, that's all. Diksha means Guru gives Dibbagan and divine knowledge, Dibbagan, and Kurjat Papasya Sanchayam. And he destroys and burns all kind of sin. If we take Harinam as before, here there is some sin, but Guru by Diksha Mantra burns all things. Somebody says that, oh, Gurudev takes all sin from Sissa, so Gurudev used to suffer. It is not correct. If it
common point.
No.
Actual point.
So Diksha Mantra will take us up the gate of Vaikuntha, not beyond Vaikuntha.
No, this is not my question. What is the difference between Harinam and
Diksha will take up the gate of Vaikuntha and Diksha Mantra will give us relationship. And holy name take us to Braj. Just like Gopkumar, he received Gopal Mantra from his Gurudev and he went before up to Vaikuntha. But when he get Nam, then he went beyond Vaikuntha. Harinam is prominent, but Diksha matured the Harinam.
I went to cook. I was cooking. Fire was there. I mean, chulla.
Stove
was there. Pot was there. Fire was there. Water was there. Everything was there. But not rice. Cooking will be done or not?
No.
So take this Nam as a rice. But without the help of chulla,
stove,
water, fire, pot, it cannot be boiled. But if all things are there but not rice there, no use. But if there is rice, everything is rice. When we will have all these things, then we can boil it and drink it. Understand? Understand by example? Now you can hear more. Name is himself Krishna and Radha. Or Krishna is. This is like rice. And fire and all other things, to make it realized and to make it, to realize that name is himself Krishna, all are required. To purify myself, not to purify Krishna name. Krishna name is always Namah Chintamani, Krishna Rashi Chaitanya Vigraha, Purna Subha, Nitya Mukta, Abhinat Patana. Krishna is same as his name, no different. Name Kavan cannot be impure, always pure, always Chinmay, Sachidananda. But according to our stage, we cannot take it as pure name, or we can take pure name. Understand? If we are full of ignorance, full of all kinds of worldly desires, full of unnecessary, so many times, and full of offenses, then what we will utter Krishna name will not be Krishna name. At that time you are standing on the platform of Maya, avidya. So that name will not be true. So to give a very test in taking name, to purify our heart, to have link, a relationship between Krishna and myself, this name and myself, and to give up away all kinds of anartha, avidya, diksha is needed. As fire is needed to boil water, but only boiling water will not do, there's some rice should be there. So, diksha is given to purify our heart and have a link with Krishna, so that very soon we can realize that Krishna is himself, name is himself Krishna. So, now you understand, diksha is to help the relationship between Krishna and that devotee, that Gopi Janna Ballabhaya Swaha. Swaha means, I am offering myself, I am dedicating myself fully in the lotus feet of Krishna. Which Krishna? Name Krishna, name Brahma. With what relation? That the same relation with gopis to Gopi Jana Vallabha. By this relationship we should take, if name, giving of all Sha, the Sha, the Divyam Jnanam Dadati, gives Divya Jnana. What this relationship? This is Divya relationship, that Krishna is my beloved. Whether he is male or female devotee, no heart. So this relation, with this relation, Diksha gives this relation. If you are not taking Diksha, this relationship will not be there. And you will not be able to give up all your worldly desires and all that. So it adds and helps. But we said that if anyone has not taken initiation means diksha here, only name, like Haridas Thakur has no initiation. There are so many examples for this. No initiation.
But yet chanting and being the association of very realized devotee, precept Krishna thing. But it is rare. So we should come to the rules and the regulations. So we must take each other. If you are thinking that I am like Haridas Thakur, so now I think that you have properly realized this thing. What is the difference between name and diksha? Only diksha is there, but he is not taking name. What will be? If you are taking, not taking name, but only diksha mantra. Take out the Krishna name from that Gopal mantra. Swaha, swaha.
Liberation
at best. No liberation.
Nothing.
If Krishna is taken from that mantra, what remains? Nothing, zero. So, name has two function with some swaha, namaskar, nama, cling, string, all these things. Bij mantra, and there are some swaha, namaskar. It gives some special kind of power to give up all these bad things. Without that you cannot. Name can also do, but why you should use it? You should not use for this thing. Very little things can do this thing. Why? So, name only can do everything, but it will take very long process. But by this, our rishis, our devotees has invented. So quickly, how we can develop our Krishna name into Subha, pure name, and that is like the child is given. In our disciplic order, the child. Now what? He has given. I'm not telling other than Swamiji. Or if you are telling that, you are not telling the same word. That if I am telling same word, we cannot understand. What are the modes behind Swamiji? Hard for explaining.
A Madhyama Adhikari has received spiritual initiation from the spiritual master and has been fully engaged by him in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. The Madhyama Adhikari should be considered to be situated midway in devotional service. The Uttama Adhikari, or highest devotee, is one who is very advanced in devotional service. He is not interested in blaspheming others. His heart is completely...
And Uttama Adhikari is not interested in...
blaspheming others.
Means?
Ninda.
His heart is completely clean, and he has attained the realized state of unalloyed Krishna consciousness. According to Rupa Goswami, the association and service of such a Mahabhagavata or perfect Vaishnava are most desirable.
He should, again I am telling, he should be the disciple of the same Guru or any Guru. So not telling that among my disciples only. Never he will write like this. In any books, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Upanishad, in Srimad Bhagavatam, who has initiated Parikshit Maharaj? Who was the Guru of Parikshit Maharaj? He has not initiated him.
Krishna.
But Parikshit Maharaj is telling that he is my Gurudev. And he is associating with him and hearing Harikatha from him. So
So you should think like this. If I'm not initiated by only by my Gurudev, and he will not be Vaishnava, this word is offensive. Anywhere in such sampradaya, especially in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sampradaya, he is coming. And he is qualified, and he is Vaishnava. Even Madhyamadhikari, he should be honored, and he should be heard.
One should not remain
very carefully this line.
One should not remain a Kanista Adhikari.
I'm always telling this.
Yes.
Some are telling that you should always be book distributing always. And making money. Whole life. And this will take you to Golok Vrindavan in the service of Gopi Prem. Quite absurd. Quite absurd. That's what telling, I'm thinking that foolish. Swamiji is not telling this. That is Ashtukriti, it must be done. For newcomers, one new fire, they must do all these things, what Swamiji has told. But they should know. Only this book is to be told not to. They should go deep in his purpose. Then it will be done. A man only distributing lakhs and lakhs births, he will do coming and going in birth and death. He will have some sukriti. Swamiji has not told that one should remain always in a Kanishta Adhikari. He has not told. He had told that one should not remain a Kanishta Adhikari for all this. But we are insisting that this should be like that. And this is the highest topic of service. It is like bluffing them. Quite bluffing them. We should not bluff anybody. Why they are then falling? They are blessed persons for their own gain. 25% giving and 75% pop coming in. Swamiji is saying everything. You cannot tolerate. So we should be, one should not remain in a Kanishta Adhikari. He should try by hearing. And greed will come if he is hearing a bona fide Vaishnava. If he is cultivating and obeying the orders of Vaishnava, Swamiji, he must be in Madhyam Adhikari. And Madhyam Adhikari will go to Uttam Adhikari. And Uttam Adhikari will go to Krishna Prem. In Vastu Siddhi, we have not come to always being in the same Kanishta Adhikari. And offending, making offenses. Yeah. Anyone learned his self-care by always being a Kanishta Adhikari. Then, one who is situated on the lowest.
One should not remain a Kanishta Adhikari.
All try to become Madhyam Adhikari. And those who are in Madhyam Adhikari, they should come in Madhyam. And those who are in Madhyam, they should come in Madhyam Uttam. And those who are in Uttam, they should try to realize Swarup Siddhi. And after Swarup Siddhi, Swamiji has written everything. Shravan Dasha, Varan Dasha, Smarana Dasha, then Bhavapan Dasha, Sampatti Dasha, all he has written. But we have no chance to go through these books, only to read books. And this will do, take us to that
house. So, if one is hearing from Rasik Vaishnava,
Rasik Vaishnava or Tattvagya Vaishnava, Madhyam Adhikari,
advancing from Kanishta to Madhyam,
stage, then if that person is still distributing books, is that Sukriti?
No harm, no harm. It is, then at that time it is bhakti. Hmm. This thing to distribute books is bhakti.
But it's a level of consciousness of the person who's distributing.
Yes, anything. A man is brooming. It is not in among 64 kinds of bhakti. But it will be the highest topic of brooming in the kunj. So everything, what we should not do, or we are doing, sometimes nonsense also, for worldly persons, it becomes highest service of Krishna. But it depends on that stage. No? So we must try to go in Madhyamadhikari, and Madhyamadhikari should try to go in Uttamadhikari. So Swami Maharaj is not telling that one should not remain a Kanishtha Adhikari forever, he should go. But he should try to go. If he is not trying, then we should think that his association is not good. There is some lackness, leakage on that. Either in his guru, either in himself. His guru is not complete. So try to give up that guru. If our eagerness is not coming, our enthusiasm is not coming, and we are not trying to develop our Krishna consciousness from Kanishka Adhikari to Madhyama, that guru should be given up.
So one should not remain a Kanistha Adhikari, or one who is situated on the lowest platform of devotional service and is interested only in worshipping the deity.
Only worshipping, thousand years. But not serving any high class of Vaishnava. It will not do. If you want to develop, you can do worship. But at time also you will have to develop your Krishna consciousness by association of Uttam Rasik Vishnu. Otherwise, what?
Gurudev, I was wondering what is the minimum qualification of a...
You should hear all these things. And gradually all questions will be solved. But hear very patiently and very deeply.
Such a devotee...
Try to don't take your mind on other subject. What here we are dealing, we should try to observe one thing only. Don't go out of line. Only the thing I am giving here. What Swamiji is telling. Try to understand that word, the deep meaning of the sentence, and the word. Then you can get that.
A person who is faithfully engaged in the worship of the deity in the temple, but who does not know how to behave towards devotees or people in general, is called a Prakriti Bhakta or Kanistha Adhikari.
You should know what is Kanistha Adhikari. And then take your hand here and judge yourself that in what Adhikari you are, what stage you are. You can easily think that in what Adhikari you are. Otherwise, and then try to get it. Hmm. Who is Kanishtha Adhikari? Oh, yes? There is no association of any good Vaishnava and only worshipping and thinking himself that I am more than he. He will not. If he wants to give anyone coming and give him so much money, then he will take that. If I am not honoring him, then he may go, and he will take. He will not give money. So I should honor him. So he will take the garland of Thakurji and give how, like this. He will not touch. He will throw it. Like you will go to Bihariji Mandir, any mandir of all
Goswamis who are Kanishta Adhikari, they will need to devotees who are Uttam Mahabhagavata. If Sukhdev Goswami will come, Nath will come, they will throw like this. Because they don't know anything. They think that, oh, that deity is not mine. So this deity can be dishonored. But this is my Thakur. And this is only to be honored, not honored. Why they are giving donation to that deity? They should all give to my. He's not thinking that my deity is everywhere. My deity is full Krishna. Because they have no developed their Krishna consciousness. You should try to develop in such a way. I think that it is now called. Now, Gaur Pramanande. I think this will be interesting for you. Also to realize Swamiji teaching. I'm not telling anything, but I'm telling the words of Swamiji. Don't think that I'm telling anything separate from that.
One thing I remember, your explanation on Diksha, there's one purport where Srila Prabhupada, he explains, just like you have explained about that.
Yes.
Exactly like that. In Chaitanya Charitamrita.
Anywhere you will see in any authentic book, you will see like this. So you should try to hear, because I think that you have not so much opportunity to be with Swami. And such practically with direct relation. I have that occasion. I am lucky to have him for more than 50, 60 years. So you can understand. And you can definitely.
Srila Gurudev Ki Jai!
Not Gurudev.
Yes.
I'm devotee. Very. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Yes.
Well, the only thing is it's unedited and it took so much of it, it would be hard to get the right parts. We'd have to look over it first and just put it to our little video. Sometimes before we leave, okay. Let me get it together before you ask.
I don't know.
The day before I went on the Purnima, because we were going to spend so long to ride, because that was to be like the day before the leaves. So it would be like 3 days if you do it.
There was a time when the devotees, they began to fall. Many devotees began falling. Then he said there should be 5 classes a day. That's a fact.
And I'm doing from very beginning all these things. So I have very little chance to go down.
Go, Premanande!
Yes, or take not only my picture, but these things. Checking?
Yes. I want you to meet Tilak. She preached to me before I was a devotee. She made me devotee. This is Tilak. She's Prabhupada
and her husband Navadvipa.
Yes. I'm so
very old devotees of Srila Prabhupada.
And I become so happy if I meet any sincere and senior devotee. You should try to come nearer to me to help me.
Oh, yes, right.
I want help.
I try to help at every opportunity.
Yeah.
I was able to get some mercy on your first book, I believe, in the West. Govinda Lilamrita.
Govinda Lilamrita.
Yeah, I was able to enter the Die Critics. I also wanted to print it, but I lost that opportunity. I think you had it printed in India.
Yes.
Yes.
I want to again print it in London. They have a scheme for plan for this. I want to print all these books, thousand and thousand.
He knows the name.
I'm good friends with Pray Raka. When he was collecting, I was able to give some donations.
Oh, he has helped me so much that I'm always
indebted.
He's my inspiration also.
So you should help me.
I will not.
We called Prakashara last night and his son spoke to him.
Good day. In Bhakti Sandarbha,
let me take Prakti.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Very little in my face. Continue.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
So wonderful. Everyone loves to hear you speak like this.
Hare Bol, 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 Hare Bol. Dayo, Dayo, Guru De, Guru De, Guru De. Daya Guru De,
Daya Daya
Guru De, Guru De, Guru De, Guru De.
Wonderful class.
Yes, very wonderful. It's to go see Ki Jai.
I want to give classes like this.
You should stay here a long time.
Also, we have become, should be helped. My doctor is calling me.
Mommy.
You are Dr. Rudy.
He is nurse.
Oh, you are happy? I wanted to see your dancing. Oh, like that?
Bharatanatyam. She says she'll dance for you alone in the room, but not in front of everyone because she's shy.
come
alone in my room.
The holy name being like rice, and the pots and the fire and everything is there, and within the chanting of the Gayatri, the rice is really the center that is aiding us to chant purely the holy name.
In the holy name and in the chant, which is more important and prominent. Prabhu, Vaishnavananda Prabhu.
Harinam.
Hi. Hi. How?
The holy name of Krishna is not different than Krishna himself.
Yes. And other things? Mantra?
The picture is merely to clear away anats.
Not only to clear anats, but strengthen the relationship.
Sambandha.
Marriage is needed. When there is no marriage, only it has been told that you will be married to that person. But if marriage is done, after that no ceremony, nothing is done. That he is my servant, he is my husband, always like to. But up to that time, marriage is not done. A lady can think of, when will you be married? When will you be married? Very sweet thing will be. But after marriage, before marriage, if you are meeting to that new coming husband, that anyone can tell, oh, she's got her character is not okay. But after marriage, no need of doing again marriage. So, when we are in sadhana, don't do all these things. Oh, if it is a mantra is needed in worldly sadhana, and if we have sarva siddhi, and after that we are coming to vastu siddhi, no need of mantra. Then, my beloved, where you are, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu called when we went to Jagannath. Krishna mantra hoita hai sansar mochan. Krishna naam hoita pai Krishna pai. Mochan means? Mochan means, what is the meaning of mochan? Where is no deep? No deep near. No deep near. Tum batla sakta hai, tum bhi baitha ka 5 mil dur. You will sit 5 miles away from me.
What is
meaning?
Help to clear away.
But not to clear away. The without mantra, we have no relation with Krishna. In this world, having this relationship, and we can chant name, then we can purify more and have realized the, all these things in sadhana dasa and in ripen matured dasa. It will come clearly. When mango is in, not ripen, but pure, matured, not ripen, but matured. Understand?
Yes, green.
Not green.
Full, but not.
It has gone to his say. But there is difference between ripen and between. No taste. So when we are practicing, everything we will do in this world. We will learn all these things. In Swarup Siddhi and in Vastu Siddhi, all will clear. And practically we will do this. Like very babies having to dolls, one lady and one woman, a man, they make marriage. Very little baby, they don't know what is marriage, but it's still little. But doing so, when they are married, then everything they know. So practicing everything in sadhana dasa. Sadhana te karibe jaha,
sadhana bhavibe jaha,
siddhi te paibe jaha. What you will think in sadhana? Like, I am friend of Krishna, I am following Siddham, Subal, Madhu Mangal, I am obeying them, I am very good, beautiful shape of cowherd. And if you will give up this body thinking like so, a very good, a transcendental self will come. And really, you will feel that. Like Bharat Maharaj, he was thinking of deer and left his body and he became deer. Why he will not? Surely. So in sadhana part we will think, in siddhi the same thing there. Ashtakali Leela is, if you are doing and serving Krishna in a special mode, that a special mode will come back after that. If you are obeying proper, in proper way, yeah, you should come here, always sit here, nearby. No? So, in sadhana avastha, abhakti, all our activities and all our cultivation are not actually bhakti, not sadhana. When we, our object is to have bhav bhakti, what we are cultivating, our all senses, by all senses,
practicing.
Then, having the mood that I will have bhava bhakti, then it will be sadhana. Otherwise, it is sadhana bhash. Sadhana abhash.
Abhash, you know? Semblance of sadhana.
Semblance of sadhana. Not actually sadhana. Because you don't know anything about sadhana and what is your goal.
knowing all your goals and how to cultivate your all senses of bhakti, then it may be sharpened. And when the object of our mood, bhava bhakti, will be swarup siddhi, Krishna prem, then it will be bhava bhakti, otherwise not bhava bhakti. So we should clear all these things. Then we can proceed on sadhana. Otherwise we cannot do any sadhana. Only chanting will not do. Those who are chanting, some becomes like mayavadi, some sajiya, some has some worldly gains, some are involved in mukti, some go to Narayan Lok, some to Ajodhya, some to Dwarka, Mathura Puri, and among them so rare go to Krishna in Braja, and in them rare to Dasya Bhakti of Krishna, and in them rare to Krishna as a Sakha, Siddhamsa. Very, very rare are like Nanda Baba and Yashoda. And very among them, very rare. What thing? Mahabhagavas. And in them, very rare in the line of Rupa Goswami. We are coming in this line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Rupa Goswami. Sri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sahabitam Jena Gultare Swayam Rupa Tadamaya Tadavishtam. Anyone knowing not all these things, uttering this sloka, he has no realization at all what the meaning of this sloka. What is this Swapadam Tikam? He will not. So we must, I think, our classes are going well, like East Goshti. you are free to question anything. I'm now beginning my Srimad Bhagavat class. In morning we will discuss about the Samrita and all these teachings, how we can enter in bhakti. Also, this will add it. It will make greed Bhagavatam. I want to clear one thing more. What is the basic difference between Gita and Bhagavatam? Some devotees have the opinion that I don't regard Gita. Myself, I disregard Gita. But this is the same thing with Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swamiji. He had not disregarded, and I am also not meant to disregard Gita. But sometimes I say like Swamiji, I have read anywhere, you may remember, that Gita is first book of
ABC.
And Srimad Bhagavatam, post graduate, PhD, last book. Why he has told like so? He has disregarded Gita? By telling. This is the fact. But for beginners, it is not told like so. Otherwise, their faith, they will lose their faith. Na janayet karma sangina.
Na buddhi bheda janayet.
Na buddhi bheda janayet karma sangina. Don't disturb karma. They should gradually come towards devotional services. So, something is told for them. Gita is essential because it is the ground. But you know, you should know this fact. Vyasadev has divided Vedas in four. Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda, Atharva Veda. He has explained Gita, Upanishads,
he had done compiled almost all 18th Purans, 18th Upapuran, 18th Shakha Puran, 36 Purans. He had done Mahabharata, 18th Parva,
Canto.
Also Gita is 18th chapters of same Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, of same Mahabharata. It was finished, it was compiled, but yet Vyasa was not satisfied. And he was not thinking that, why I am not pleased? My Atma is not so happy. Why? Gita was there. He had done in Mahabharata. And it was prominent. But yet, why he was not satisfied? So Gita was there, but he was not satisfied. But when Srimad Bhagavat was compiled, then he became happy. But there is something lacking in Gita. It is for beginners, no doubt. But for advanced, nothing is there. There is only Saranagati, which is the door of bhakti. The door is not itself bhakti, but it gives entrance in bhakti realm. And that is why, you know, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that Sarvadharman Pratyajam, he told that, oh, it is by you. It is
external.
That is why. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was dishonoring Gita by telling this. What he was telling? So, doing comparison is not bad thing, not dishonoring. When we will tell that Ram, Krishna is Supreme Personality of God. Ram is same by Siddhanta. Siddhanta tas abhede api. Krishna
Saparupayo.
Rasen utkashyate Krishna. Rupamesha rasasthiti. By Ras, Krishna is Supreme. So this is not dishonoring Ram, not dishonoring Mahavishnu or Dwarkadhish by telling this. So Swamiji Maharaj has not dishonored Gita. Because in itself in Srimad Bhagavata it is written that he was not happy, he was lacking something. At that time Gita was done. Mahabharata was done. Still he was not happy. But there is something like him. No prem there. How to develop Krishna consciousness? Prem, this system is not there. Only out external things like doing saranagati. Getting all knowing tattva established. In fact, this is the main object of Gita. That we are not this body. We are not mind, we are part and parcel of Krishna. And it has not been clearly said that. It has been told, but in a covered way. What has been told in Srimad Bhagavat and Chaitanya Chaitamrita very vividly, in the dialogue of Sanatana Goswami, everything is clear that. In Gita it is not clear. How to love Krishna? It is not all there. That is why we are coming to conclusion by Srimad Bhagavatam. For Srimad Bhagavat it has been told that Nigama Kalpataror Galitam Phalam Sukamukhad Amrita Davasanjutam Pivata Bhagavatam Rasamalayam Muhuraho Rusika Bhubham. For Gita it has been told. Sarva Upanishado Gao
Dubdha Gupala Nandana Partho Vasa Sudhir Bhokta Gita Matam Mahat. Compare this sloka. For the glorification of Gita, it has been told, Sarv Upanishado Gao. All the Upanishads are like cows. Krishna is milk. And Vatsavane, calf is Arjun. Arjun is in the place of calves. Milk is not, all milk is not for calves. Malisham and other milks is for Sudhir, Bhakta. Those who are Sudhi. Sudhi means Bhakta. Their buddhi is so sthir. Wisdom is sthir. Mind is established, not going anywhere. That they want to become Bhakta. They want to come in the line of Bhakti. So they are Sudhi. So this Gita is for them, for primary stages. That you are not, this body is not myself, our mind is not ourself. You should tolerate all the worldly things. And you should think that I am part and parcel of Krishna. Mai vamso jiva loke jivuta sanatana. Be sthiti pragya. Sthiti pragya means? What is the meaning of sthiti pragya?
Unwavering
knowledge,
unwavering
understanding. That I am sure, part and parcel of Krishna. We have nothing to do with worldly things. We should not be attached in worldly things. Be fixed. Do your fixed your mind in Krishna consciousness. This is sthiti pragya. Eat sukh and dukh. Hani, Maran, Jivan, Lav. That death and birth, suffering and sorrows, hotness and coldness, all kinds of suffering may come. You should tolerate. These are for very few moments. So you should tolerate and always engage your mind, your body, your soul, everything in Krishna consciousness, all your senses. He is telling to engage, but not engaged still. And if we will offer all practices and everything to the lotus feet of Krishna, surrendering ourselves, then Krishna easily may give all these things. And he will make us enter in bhakti realm. But our effort will not do. Our effort is very weak. But Krishna will be so strong. In a moment he can turn anyone. So we should not have so much faith on our activities in our sadhana bhajan, but we'll have faith on Krishna. If you are avoiding the rules of Vedic culture, giving of wife, giving of sons, giving of husband, giving of your Gurudev, if he is not in helping mood, no harm. Krishna is telling that I will excuse everything. You should take shelter in me. So, Nigama Kalpataru Rugalitam.